Grief is overwhelming. So much so that at times I am no longer recognizable to those who love me.
She's one of hundreds who gathered to honor the Ufsal family. A year ago, while out for a walk, Yumna, Madiha, Salman, and Talat were run down. It was an attack police called hate motivated.
That's absolutely horrifying, especially since the liberals blew up their countries. And I'd like to thank the Muslims that invited me out of Facebook and into live action of the war zones that Obama and the quiet Canadians did nothing while they blew up their countries for democracy. That was the excuse they used. So this is horrific, absolutely horrific, CBC. But it's nothing compared to what you're doing to the natives still. You have the natives, small population, 6% or less in British Columbia. 40% live downtown East End, Vancouver. None of these people have to live there. And in fact, they won't even go to their shop that they opened up, their Muslim shop, anymore downtown Vancouver. And I don't blame them, but I really appreciate the East Indians that bring food once a week, even throughout the pandemic, rain and snow, for the vulnerable. I appreciate them. I appreciate the Muslims trying, but it was pretty overwhelming for them. And so they closed up shop and there's homeless tents there. So the only people that we have helping down here are the Sikhs, East Indians, and the Christians. Occasionally, natives will come down here and help. But quite frankly, they're already a broken persons, and they have the most discrimination against them in Canada. Now, if you're a Muslim terrorist and you spend time in a prison, you get $10 million. But if you're abducted from your family, you witness murders, you survive, you lose your brother or sister, you get $40,000. Now that's racism. I do not want people being racist against the Muslims whatsoever. It's not their fault that they get two or three times the welfare rate as Canadians. You do not blame them. What they've gone through in these countries that Obama bombed the shit out of is horrific. They've already suffered lots. But CBC, you fucking suck. Because on your comment sections with the natives, you left the comment section open. And I had to read a lot of racism from ignorant British Columbians. So maybe you should be promoting more that we actually have been abducting native children since 1830 something to 1996. The government was responsible for every child that they failed that showed up in mass graves. The government lied to the parents that demanded to see their children. The government called the children that witnessed murders liars. And you left the comment section open for that. So I had to, you know, make a lot of fucking comments. Pissed off at all the racism in that native comments. You guys have created hatred for the natives. They're traumatized, the most traumatized people in Canada or in North America. And they're kept that way by the government and the silent peoples.